Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Alibaba here again. How you doing, everyone? Now, what we're going to get into is keyframes. Okay, I want to explain keyframes. They're really important. They're a way of that allows you to insert certain information, especially when it comes to animation and stuff like that. You set keyframes to tell the system at this point this is going to happen, and that's pretty much the easiest way to explain it. What I want to show you is when you open up Flash for the first time, you'll notice that in our stage we have nothing and in our timeline we have nothing. You can see that by having this circle, and it has basically a circle with nothing in it. Okay, this is telling us that at present there is nothing in our timeline. What I want to do is I'm going to draw myself a lovely little ball. This is going to be our ball. Now I want you to imagine this is a basketball or a football, whatever you want to call it. This is our ball. For the purpose of this tutorial, this is a ball. Now when we add this ball, okay, and what I'm actually going to do quickly is I'm just going to convert that into a symbol. Doesn't matter which one, I'm just going to convert it into a movie one. Okay, now when you've added a shape or you added something to the stage, to that layer, you will automatically get inserted a keyframe. Now a keyframe is this black dot. You can see that that is a keyframe. Now what I want to show you is I want to show you how relevant is that when you set a keyframe, that is the information that's going to happen. Let me explain. A frame, let's say frame 10, I'm going to right click and I'm going to insert a frame. Now you'll notice at present there is only one keyframe, which basically means that at present this ball is only to the left. If I come all the way up to frame 10 where we inserted the frame, the ball does not move. If I was to select this ball and just say move it anywhere, you will now notice that that is the new position for that ball because we are only working with one keyframe. Let me move this ball back to where it was, okay? And what I want to show you is how to insert a new keyframe. Now I'm going to right click on frame 10 and I'm going to insert a keyframe. And there we go. So we now have two bits of information. We have two points of information where we can animate this ball. The first point of information is the ball is to the left, and at present the second keyframe at frame 10 is the ball to the left. So what we can do is we can set at frame 1 we want the ball to be the left, and at frame 10 we can then move the ball and have it to the right. Okay, so what we have now is we have two bits of information. We have a point set from frame 1 to frame 9 the ball is to the left, and at frame 10 we set a key point, a keyframe, for the ball to be to the right. Okay, so it's by setting keyframes it allows you to set information to certain points. If I wanted to explain this a bit better, on keyframe 10, if I move this to the bottom, that is now the new position for that keyframe. Okay, so frame 1 to frame 9 is the same position. Frame 10, the ball has now moved down to the bottom. Okay, now how do you move a keyframe? Now when working with many layers, sometimes moving a keyframe could be very handy. The way to move a keyframe, so let's say I want to move this from frame 10 to frame 20, I just left click on the, hold my left finger down on the mouse button, drag all the way to frame 20, and that will extend our keyframes from frame 1 to frame 19, the ball is animated to the left. On frame 20, the ball is animated to the right. Okay, so by setting keyframes, you're setting individual points of information on what is going to happen to the object that's on the stage, in our case this ball. And we're setting at frame 1 to frame 19, the ball's to the left. At frame 20, the ball is to the right. Now what I want to show you quickly is a way of blending in these keyframes. We're going to go over this again later on when it gets to animation, but what I want to do quickly is I want to select frame 1. Okay, I want to select the keyframe on frame 1. I want to right click and I want to create a classic tween. Now remembering that we set frame 1, we set the ball to the left. Frame 20, we set the ball to the right. And before, from frame 1 to 19, the ball was always to the left. By creating a classic motion tween, the system will now know, okay, that we wanted the ball started at the left, the ball ends at the right, so the system makes all those frames in between blend from that frame where the ball's to the left to where the ball is to the right. Okay, now I'm doing this to show you that, you know, you can set up tweens in between frames to allow you to animate something, and also show you that these are each individual points. Now, if I move this over to frame 10, in CS4, what you can do by adding a new keyframe here or animating this ball in a different way in CS4. I don't think you can do it in CS3 and the other versions, but what you do is left click, you drag the ball down, okay, and you watch, you'll notice that the system has inserted another keyframe for us. So this ball being at the bottom here is another point of the animation, okay? So point one at the animation was the ball was at the left. We then, keyframe 10, we set the ball to be at the bottom. Keyframe 20, the ball goes to the right. The system adds the tween in between, which now makes the effect of the ball bouncing to the bottom and to the top. Okay, so this you can sort of see by setting key points for keyframes, setting points, you know, of your animation, and then, like I say, adding a tween, but we're going to go over this in the animation section. You can start to blend that point to the middle keyframe that we set, to the top 20 frame that we set the ball to be to the right. I'll quickly show you how to delete a keyframe. You can click on the frame. Quickly show you how you can delete a keyframe. You can just basically right click on that frame, come down to clear keyframe, and that now animates the ball to go from left on frame 1 to the right on frame 20. So I just wanted to show you a quick overview of actually what frames do, keyframes do, okay? In the next tutorial, what we're going to do is start getting into keyframes and frames and adding our own frames, adding more layers and showing you ways and shortcuts of actually deleting keyframes and stuff, just so you can start moving on your projects. The basic overview: a keyframe allows you to insert information for your animation, and you're just setting the point of where the animation starts and where the animation ends and what happens in between from start to end. If you want to insert more keyframes, it's entirely up to you. Take it easy, guys and girls. Hope I haven't confused you more. Catch you at the next one-stop tutorial.